after opening as a valve, you are allowed to convert it into a single system. So with an equilibrium temperature of 27 degrees Celsius. After you have a system, so A and B are mixed, you have to achieve the temperature of equilibrium temperature of 27 degrees Celsius. So before the mixing, the following information to know about the gases in the two vessels. So if we're considering a vessel A, so in a vessel A, we have pressure that is equal to pressure of, that is a P of A is equal to, normally that is 1.5 megapascal. Then at the next, then temperature, that is a T is equal to 50 degrees Celsius. Then we having the content, that is nothing but here, vessel A, the given the condition is nothing but in terms of molar basis. So N is equal to, so 0.5 kilogram mole. But in the vessel B, the same content the given, that is a temperature, here you can write temperature of A. There is a P of B. So P of B is equal to 0.6 megapascal. And the temperature of B is equal to 20 degrees Celsius. And the content that was given in the vessel B in terms of mass basis. So M of, here right, N of E. Here that is M of B is equal to 2.5 kg. So here both the vessels having the gases of nitrogen, here also gases of nitrogen. So this is about the given data. So vessel A and B, both are filled with the nitrogen. So conditions of vessel A, this is the condition of vessel A, this is the condition of vessel B. So both are in the two chambers with separated by one bar. After opening the valve, what happened? So after opening of valve, so A and B, that is mixed together, both the gas having nitrogen, that is allowed to temperature of 27 degrees Celsius. One is 50 degree, another is 20 degree. It reaches the temperature of 27. Then next parameter, what are the parameter that you're going to find? Next one is, that is, what are the parameter that you're going to find? Calculate the final equilibrium pressure and the amount of heat transfer to the surroundings. Now, what about the final equilibrium pressure? The temperature equilibrium is given as a 27 degrees Celsius. Then final equilibrium pressure is what? Then what about the amount of heat transfer? So heat transfer, that is after mixing. So after mixing, how much amount of heat is transferred? Because one is 50, one is 20 degrees Celsius. So it comes to the 27 degrees Celsius after the mixing. So how much amount of heat is released? This is the first condition. Then second condition, read the problem. If the vessel is, this is the second condition, if the vessel has been perfectly insulated, calculate the final temperature and pressure which should have been reached. Take gamma equal to 1.4. So second condition, what about the temperature and pressure of final condition? Otherwise after equilibrium, otherwise it can be taken as, that is taken as a temperature F for your convenience. You can take a temperature and pressure at a F, because at the final condition, if it is insulated, what insulated? The system is completely insulated. There is no way of heat transfer. There is no way of heat transfer. It is a perfectly insulated. Then take a gamma equal to 1.4. So these are the given data. Then what you're going to find? So if it is fine, the first one is you're going to find the pressure and amount of heat transfer if system is not insulated. So in that case, the system is not insulated. In that case, system is insulated, but in the case system is insulated, what about the pressure and temperature? Okay, now we move on to the problem. So listen, first we're going to find M of A. Otherwise, you are going to find the M of A as well as the, here you are going to find the N of A. For better convenience, we are going to find M of A, and here you are going to find the N of B. So it is easy for calculation. Okay, another parameter that you are going to know is, both the gases are nitrogen, so you consider the molecular weight, that is a mu of N2, otherwise M of N2, which is equal to 28 kilogram per kilogram mole. So 28 kilogram per kilogram. There is a molecule weight of nitrogen. Okay, now we move into the problem. That is nothing but the solution. Okay, first you are going to find the V of A. First you are going to find V of A, otherwise that is mass of A. So first you are going to find mass of gas. There is a mass of gas in vessel A. So already you know the formula. The number of moles is equal to mass of A divided by, that is, molecular weight of A. Here you are going to find the mass of A. So mass of A is nothing but number of moles of A into molecular weight of A. So number of moles of A is nothing but, that is, 0.5. So in the substitution, you write the unit, so which is easy for the converting, into molecular weight, that is nothing but molecular weight is equal to 28 kilogram per, that is, a kilogram mole. So kilogram mole gets cancelled. Finally, you get the 28 into 0.5. So mass of A is nothing but, that is nothing but 14 kilogram. Mass of A is nothing but the 14 kilogram. Okay, then you find the mass of A. So mass of A is nothing but 14 kilograms. So otherwise you are going to calculate the N of B. So that we'll discuss in the discuss later. Next we are going to find the volume. Next you find the volume of gas in vessel A. Next, we find the volume of gas in the vessel A. So, how we find the volume? So, from the formula, so P of A is into, that is, a V of A is equal to, that is, N of A into, that is, R bar T. This is the formula. P V equal to N R T. N R bar T. So, from the substitution, so V A is equal to, that is, N A R bar T divided by, that is called as a P of A. Divided by P of A. Here N of A is nothing but, that is, 0.5 kilogram mole into R is equal to 8.314. What is the unit? What is the unit of R bar? What is the unit of R bar?
Kilojoule per kilogram. Gram.
Kilojoule per kilogram mole. That is Kelvin. Okay, well, kilojoule per kilogram mole Kelvin into temperature. We can be read, for the temperature of A, it is equal to 50 degree Celsius. So 50 degree Celsius is nothing but, we can be right, that is 2323 Kelvin. So in a temperature, you have to be written as 323 Kelvin. So first we will convert it into Kelvin. So after substituting the value, we can get the V of A, which is equal, divided by, it is, pressure. Here, pressure. So in a pressure, you are going to return in terms of, the value is nothing but the 1.5 megapascal. So 1.5 into 10 to the power of 6 mega, that can be written as a 10 to the power of 6 pascal, that can be written as Newton per meter square. Again, I repeating, when you are going to substitute a pressure in a PV equal to NRD or MRT equation, the pressure must be in a unit of Newton per meter square. So in the 10, so here the 15 to 10 to power 6 can be possibly written in terms of kilonewton per meter. How we can write the kilonewton per meter square? So 1.5 into, here 10 to power of 3, 10 to power 6 can be split up into 10 to power of 3, into, that is, 10 to power of 3. So 10 to 1, 10 to power of 3 you kept as a constant. The another 10 to power of 3, that goes to, that is, a kilonewton per meter square. So substituting the pressure in terms of kilonewton per meter square. So after substituting the values, you can get the value, that is, a VA, which is equal to 0.895 meter cube. Substituting the value, VA is equal to, so VA is nothing but 0.895 meter cube. Okay, Then for a vessel A, you are going to find the VA and MA. For vessel B, so for a vessel B, you are going to find the VB. So volume of gas in vessel B. Okay, here I use the equation, that is a PB into VB is equal to MB or TB. So here there is a difference between these two equations. So here PV equal to N R bar T, here PV equal to M R T. So there may be difference exists. So what does that mean? So N is equal to, here this equation again you can be written in some PV. PA into VA is equal to NS is nothing but there is a mass of A divided by molecular weight of A into R bar by T. So what about the R bar divided by molecular weight? So PA is equal to VA into, that is MA. What is R bar by mu A?
R of nitrogen, gas constant.
R of nitrogen. So there is nothing but the R of, that is nothing but R of A into temperature of A. So we can be written in the both the forms, in the mole basis, otherwise in the mass basis. Here we can be written as R of B. So already you know the pressure. Here you are going to find the volume of B. Again, then volume of B is equal to M of B, then R of B, then T of B divided by, what you say, that is P of B. So here R of B is nothing but, that is R of nitrogen. So R of B is nothing but R of nitrogen. How we find the R of nitrogen? So that is defined by a symbol, that is R, universal gas constant divided by molecular weight of N2. Okay. Already you know that is value of universal gas constant, that is equal to 8.314 divided by molecular weight of nitrogen, nothing but the 28. So from that you are getting, that is R of N2 is equal to 0.297 kilojoule per kilogram Kelvin. Okay, well, you substituted the R of N2 here. Okay, so VB equal to, that is mass of B from the problem you know. So mass is nothing but the 2.5 kg. Here the 20 degrees Celsius, we can be written as Kelvin, 293 Kelvin. Pressure is 0.6 megapascal. So mass, that is equal to, say that is 2.5 kilogram into R, that is 0.297 kilojoule per kilogram Kelvin into 293 Kelvin divided by pressure, already here defined as megapascal, 0.6 megapascal. You can be written as 0.6 into 10 to power of 6 pascal. So the 10 to power of 6 can be split into 10 to power of 3 and 10 to power of 3. Okay, 10 to power of 3. So this you can be written as, that is 0.6 into 10 to power of 3, 1 10 to power of 3, this goes to kilo Newton per meter square. So pascal is nothing but Newton per meter square. So 1 pascal is equal to 1 Newton per meter square. So don't forget to find the conversion between the units of pressure. So 1 pascal is equal to 1 Newton per meter square. Okay, well. Then after substituting the appropriate values, if I get the value, that is a VB is equal to 1.258 meter cube. Okay. Okay, you find the VB. The next one you need to find the, that is the NB. Okay. NB is equal to number of moles is equal to mass of mole divided by, that is a molecular weight of B. Already we have, that is mass is equal to, mass of B is equal to 2.5 kg. Then molecular weight is nothing but how much? That is 28. So 2.5 by 28, how much you got? 0.089 kilogram mole. You find the NB also. Here it can be written that is the NB is equal to 0.089 kilogram mole. Okay. Then next we find the basic properties of A and B. Then next we find the total system. So separately we find A and B and the properties. Next we find the condition after equilibrium, after mixing. So after mixing we are going to find. So after mixing, for the problem point of view, you can take the notation, that is nothing but the E for your references. So here next you find the total volume after mixing. So total volume after mixing is, so V of total volume VT or VE, so we can be written as VE. V is nothing but that is a VA plus VB. Here in the system, already I told you having a two chambers. Two chambers are separated by a wall. Here we opening A and B, the two chambers are separated by a wall. After opening the wall, the gases are mixed with each other. Okay, there is no way of escaping out from the system. So you consider this is nothing but the system. There is no way of escaping a gases from system to surrounding. So all the gases are that is mixed with each other and enclosed in a single chamber. Okay, so therefore we add the two volumes. So VA, VB. Here VA already we find that is nothing but 895. Then VB, which is equal to 0.363. Finally, we can get the total volume, that is a VT. Otherwise, we can be written that is VE or VT. So which is equal to 1.258 meter cube. Then next one is nothing but the total mass. Next we are going to find the total mass. Here total mass we can be written as that is MT, other after equilibrium I can written as that is a ME, which is equal to M of A plus M of B. So M of A, which is equal to 14, then M of B, which is equal to 2.5. So ME other MT, which is equal to 16.5 kilogram. Okay, then final temperature. We are having a, we need a basic properties of pressure, volume, temperature, mass, and then gas constant. So we are going to find the pressure. We have a volume. We find the volume. The temperature is already given in the problem. We find the mass. We have R because both the gases are nitrogen, so we have R. So finally, we are going to find the pressure. Okay, but temperature, what the temperature that given in the problem is, okay, the mixing, after mixing, the temperature attained is 27 degrees Celsius. The temperature is 27 degrees Celsius after the mixing. So 27 degrees Celsius, so TE is equal to 27 degrees Celsius, that can be converted into Kelvin, so which is equal to 300 Kelvin. Okay, volume you we find, temperature given in the problem, mass we find, R we find. So R, which is the R of nitrogen, is that we already find, which is equal to 97 kilojoule per kilogram Kelvin. Then substituting the appropriate values in the ideal gas equation, we get the, what about the pressure? The pressure simply, which is equal to, from the D equation. So P of after equilibrium, then after equilibrium or after opening the valve, which is equal to M of E, then R of E into T of E. We are going to find the pressure. So pressure after equilibrium. So P of E is equal to, then M of E, then R of E, T of E divided by same, that is called as a V of E. Here mass, total mass, which is equal to after equilibrium, which is nothing but 16.5 kilogram into R. So R is nothing but the gas constant of R is nitrogen. So we can be written as there is 0.297 kilojoule per kilogram Kelvin into temperature, which is equal to 300 Kelvin. Then we are having a volume. So volume is equal to nothing but 1.258 meter cube. So finally, what we get there, what is the unit we got for the pressure? What we get for the pressure? So same data for the cancellation, Kelvin gets cancelled, kilogram gets cancelled. Okay, finally, after substituting, we get the value of, say, something into the unit is nothing but kilojoule divided by meter cube. But we need the unit of pressure. So again, the kilojoule, which can be written as kilo, joule can be written as kilo Newton meter divided by meter cube. Here the meter, this cube gets cancelled and converted into square. So finally we get the value of, say, that is a kilo Newton, sorry, finally we get the value of kilo Newton per meter square. So we get the pressure in terms of kilo Newton per meter square. Otherwise, we can be written in terms of a megapascal, because in the problem, both A and B can be written in terms of megapascal. If you are flexible with the unit conversion, you can be written in terms of megapascal. So in examination point of view, better you write the unit in terms what the value that what are the unit terms that followed in the question. Okay, so in a question, the unit term is in a megapascal, so convenient we can be written in terms of megapascal. So I think the value we got is 1168 kilo Newton per meter square. So finally we can get the value. What is a Newton per meter square? What is a Newton per meter square? So finally we can get 1168 kilo Newton per meter square. So which is equal to 1168 kilo Newton per meter square can be written as Pascal. Very good. Pascal. So for our convenient, so 1.168 into 10 to the power of 3 kilopascal. So again, we can be written as the 10 to the power of 3 and kilo combined to form 1.168 mega, mega pascal. So it is easy to write the pressure in terms of mega pascal. Okay. So the first part of the question, calculate the final equilibrium pressure. We find the pressure. The next, we are going to find the amount of heat transfer to the surroundings. Next, we are going to find the amount of heat transfer to the surroundings. Then how are we going to find the amount of heat transfer? Because the system is insulated. Here, this is the first case, the system is not insulated. Listen, the system is not insulated, but if there is a no work transfer, here there is a no work transfer. So in the first case, final pressure, amount of heat transfer to the surrounding. Here the system is not insulated, but there is a no work transfer. Here there is a no work transfer. No work transfer. So W is equal to zero. So from the first law of thermodynamics, here Q is equal to W plus, say there is nothing but delta E. Here in the system is going to expand. Here there is no work transfer. So automatically W comes to zero. So what are the heat transfer is equal to nothing but change in internal energy. Okay, that is nothing but the change in internal energy. Then we find the internal energy, which is equal to change in internal energy is equal to nothing but that is after mixing minus before mixing. So here that is after mixing minus before mixing. So we define the difference between these two levels of entropy. So before mixing, we are having a two categories. So first we find the before mixing. So internal energy at before mixing. You can take and this nothing but U1. U1. So U1 is equal to so MCV M into M of A, then CV of A into temperature of A plus M of B, CV of B into temperature of B. Here mass of A already known, temperature of A already known, mass of B already known, temperature of B already known. So what about the CV? Here CV of A is equal to CV of B. Here both are having nitrogen, so which is equal to CV of N2. So how we find the CV of N2? From the CV, from the relation of gamma and R, so CV is equal to R divided by gamma minus 1. This formula we already studied from the first unit. Okay, well, CV is equal to R divided by gamma minus 1. R we already find, so which is equal to 297 kilojoule per kilogram Kelvin divided by gamma that already given in the problem 1.4 minus 1. We find that is CV of N2 which is equal to 0.743 kilojoule per kilogram Kelvin. Then we substituting the appropriate value, CV of N2 is equal to CV of A and CV of B. Then U1 is equal to, we have a mass of A that is equal to MA is equal to 14 into, wait, 14 into 0.743 into temperature of A that is equal to 323 Kelvin plus mass of B is nothing but 2.5 into 0.743 into temperature B is equal to 293 Kelvin, that is nothing but 20 degrees Celsius. So after substituting the values, we can get that is U1 is equal to that is 3904 kilojoule. U1 is equal to 3904 kilojoule. So what about the U2? So U2 is equal to then internal energy after mixing. Here internal energy after mixing. You can be taken as U2. So here U2 is equal to after mixing we have to written as there is ME, then CV of V and temperature of V. Okay, MCT. Here it is equal to mass after mixing that is 16.5 into CV of V that is 0.743 into temperature is 27 degrees Celsius, we can be written as 300 Kelvin. So U2 is equal to, finally we can get, so it is equal to 3677. I think U2 is equal to 3678 kilojoule. So we find U1 and U2. Then we find what about the change in internal energy. If already find U1 and U2, so heat transfer we already know, that is heat transfer is equal to, so Q is equal to W plus delta U. Here W tends to 0 because there is no work transfer. So Q is equal to delta U, so which is equal to, that is U2 minus U1. So U2 we already find from the solution, that is U2 is equal to 3678, U1 is equal to 3904. 3678 minus 3904. Finally, approximately we can get that Q is equal to minus 226.2 kilojoule. Minus 226.2. What is the reason for we getting the negative sign? If Q is a negative, what about that?
Heat rejected to the surroundings.
It is rejected to system. So after opening of the valve, during the mixing of gases, the heat is generated. If there is any gas, that any type of gas or any mixture of gas that it going to mix with each other, at that place we are getting the exothermic or endothermic reaction based on the nature of the gases. Okay, here in the system we have one is nothing but 20, one is nothing but a 50, another one is nothing but the 20, both are mixed. If there is a fully insulated, we are getting the 30 degrees Celsius. Otherwise, maybe plus or minus something. But we are getting a 27. So definitely, there is some loss of heat takes place because the system is not insulated. Previously, I told the system is not insulated in the first cases. So therefore, the heat is to be rejected. The amount of heat rejected is equal to 226 kilojoule. The negative sign indicates that is heat is to be rejected. Rejected from system. Rejected from a system during the mixing. Okay, during the mixing, the heat is rejected from the system. Okay. Then we move on to the second case. Here, the second case, you are going to find what about the temperature and pressure. Second case, you are going to find the temperature and pressure if system is insulated. The system is insulated. Okay, if the system or vessel is insulated, if vessel or system is insulated, what about the internal energy? If the system or vessel is insulated, then U1 is equal to U2 because there is a no heat transfer. Again, from the thermodynamics equation, Q is equal to W plus delta U. Here the W goes to 0 because there is a no power chance of work transfer here. Here from the equation reduce it to Q is delta U. If the second condition system is insulated, so 0 is equal to delta U, so which is equal to U2 minus, that is a U1, so from that equation, so here U1 is equal to U2. U1 is equal to U2. If insulated. Are you clear? So in the book, in many of the book, if the system is insulated, simply it can be written as U1 minus U1 equal to U2. But how even U1 equal to U2 came? So just by the equation. So W goes to 0, Q is equal to delta in first equation. Again, so heat transfer is 0, then Q becomes 0, delta equal to 0, so U2 minus U1 is equal to 0. So from that equation, you can be written U1 is equal to U2. Here, U1 is nothing but which is equal to before mixing, U2 is nothing but the after mixing. So you write the equation. So before mixing, then M of A, then Cv of A, then temperature of A plus M of B, Cv of B, here the temperature of B, equal to M of E, Cv of E, then temperature of E. Are you understand? So this term is nothing but U1, this term is nothing but U2. Are you okay? Okay. Then here in the above equation, we can take, because Cv, therefore Cv of A, Cv of B, then Cv of E, which is equal to Cv of N2. Okay, from the above equation, you take a Cv as a constant. So Cv of N2, you can be written as, that is a M of A into T of A plus M of B into T of B equal to, here can be written as, that is Cv of E, that is equal to Cv of N2 into M of E, then T of E. here the term this and this gets cancelled. Finally, we have an equation. So m of a into t of a plus m of b into t of b, which is equal to m of e into t of e. Okay. Then here you are going to find the temperature of E. That is the temperature after the mixing the system is insulated. T of E. Okay. That is equal to M of A into T of A plus M of B into T of B divided by M of E. Then you, after the substitution, 14 into then T of A, which is equal to 323 plus here that is a 2.5 into temperature is 293 because 20 degrees is divided by 16.25. Finally, we get the temperature E. If the system is insulated after the equilibrium, we can get the temperature is normally, which is equal to 318.5 Kelvin. Otherwise, which is equal to 45.5 degree Celsius. 45.5 degree Celsius. 45.5 degrees Celsius. You can get the final temperature. Next, we are going to find the final pressure. Next, we are going to find the final pressure. So, how we find the final pressure? So, from that equation. So, P of E is equal to V of E is equal to then M of E, then R of E, then P of E. So P of E is equal to M E R of E. E refers to the final condition after the equilibrium if the system is insulated. But in the case one, the system is not insulated, divided by V of E. We have the formula. So we have the values that M is 16.5 into 0.297 temperature that is equal to 318.5. What the temperature you are find from the previous step. In most of the cases, the temperature may be written as 27. That is totally wrong. First case, the 27 is given if the system is not insulated. But the second case, if the system is insulated, what is the temperature? Then volume, we have the value that is equal to 1.258. So finally, we are getting the pressure, which is equal to, again, from substitution, we are getting the value that is 1240.7 kilo Newton per meter square. So we can be written that is a P is equal to 1240.7 that is kilo Pascal. Newton can be written as Newton per meter square and written as a kilo Pascal. Again, we written that is a PE is equal to 1.247 megapascal. For our continuing, we can be find the megapascal. So from the problem, you concluded that. From the problem, you concluded that if the system is insulated, the temperature may goes to 27 degrees Celsius after equilibrium. If the system is not insulated, if the system is not insulated after equilibrium, it reaches 27 degrees. If the system is insulated, the temperature reaches to 45.5 degrees Celsius. So this is the difference between the insulation and the non-insulation of the system after the mixing of gases in a separate vessel to single vessel. Okay.